What is going on, guys? Zephyrus here, and welcome back to some more X4 Foundations with the Star Wars Interworlds mod. Now, this is the first episode that I've been recording after most of the posts that I posted on YouTube about different names for ships. So today, that will be our first order of business. Now, I actually have already put in a couple of them. Some of the first people to comment with their preferred ship type and ship name. I have them on my second monitor just so I can make sure. So here, which is funny because it's ironic, because the moment I booted up the game and my Venator managed to get the crew of a CR-90 to bail, and one of the comments was for the SVS crop duster, literally asked for a blockade runner. So I thought that was actually pretty hilarious, that the moment they asked, one bailed, and I got it for free, basically. Do we have a captain on this? I believe we do. We need to send it back here to repair, though, because it is very, very damaged. Ooh, almost a million to repair, but good thing it's my ship, and I don't have to, or my shipyard, and I don't have to do anything. So we have the SVS crop duster as well. There's also an acquaintance here that I renamed to be the, there's another acquaintance somewhere right here. The SVS Griffin. And anybody who puts their name with captain and name, I will put that in the title of the ship as well, because I think it's pretty cool. A little bit of role play. So we have Captain Talon on the SVS Griffin. There's another one somewhere. However, they asked for an XL, and I don't have an extra XL right now, so we're going to wait until we get one for them. And then we have Captain Stukey on the SVS Crop Duster. So while that is getting repaired right now, our goal, we're a little bit down on money. So our goal is to, ooh, we have two dreadnoughts here. Awesome. Our goal is to basically get as many of these dreadnoughts from the SVS, or not the SVS, the VLS as we can. And that being said, I should probably walk to the bridge. So I'm here whenever we get up. This sector is actually really pretty. All right, so we are going to the dreadnought. Why are you not mining properly? So Bryngy, what if I move you? Come down. Sure, come down here to Dagobah. You cannot land. What if I change these? They're executing that. Awesome, you're doing your thing. And you, advanced auto trade. You do not have what it takes. It's okay. I'll just turn up your distance for travel. Boom. Perfect. Confirm. There, you should probably get something a little bit more. All right. So how about we go with all stations and let's go with unassigned ships. All right. This acclimator is doing its thing. We have our Arc 170 up here near Korriban, because I want to get one or two Sith ships, preferably two, but I think I'll only be able to manage one. But all of these ships, like all these destroyers and Terminus, have a they always have an escort. Like none of these ships are alone. With the Terminus, it only has two fighters on it, but there's usually another Terminus right behind, so that is a pain to deal with, but we will manage. As of right now, we need to fight back what we can of the Anowat Federation, because they are pretty relentless. Thankfully, we've managed to keep them at bay for the most part. That being said, let's actually grab all of you, tell them to destroy this factory, and then destroy this BAO. Nope. Never mind. That thing's gonna leave. It's fine. And they're gonna do that. We're pulling up on the dreadnought. So while that's happening, let me actually cancel out all of their orders. Remove all assignments. That did not do that. Remove all orders and assignments. There we go. And the game's gonna lag because we just canceled so many orders. Attack. Did I have my ship selected too? I did. Why does it do that? I don't know. Follow until further notice. It's the only ship I have selected, right? Not all of these. No. Why? Yeah. Okay, cool. All right, they're going to do that. They're going to be good. They're going to take care of that. And somebody said something about ships being in squadrons, and I think that's a good idea. I didn't think about it. I think we'll do squads of 10 or so. We can see. That's how many are here. 10? Yeah, awesome. All right, these are going to be set to attack with commander. All right, cool. These X-Wings are going to be set to attack with commander as well, but the TIE Defender is going to be their commander. All right, this Dreadnought is doing its own thing. Why are we lagging all of a sudden? I also noticed that my game wasn't actually on my SSD. It was on my hard drive, so I swapped it over to see if it'll run better. Doesn't seem to be running too much better, but it's fine. I prefer to run it off of my hard drive anyways. All right, SVS Crop Duster, you got repaired. Nice. All right, let's see what we can do about upgrading you. Sure, let's go with the best shield gen that we have. What is this? Boom, boom. The Kuat's a little better. It has lower regeneration, but it has higher base. So we'll run with the Kuat for the most part, just so we can get a bunch of it up. Thrusters are good. Shields are good. Turrets. Let's try to get as many as we can. Turbo lasers, awesome. Satellites, we can give these back. My crew, let's get a couple. Oh, I don't have crew on my station. Understandable. All right, that's fine. Add to shopping list. Let's get you done. And after you do that, we're actually going to move you up to the... Shall I send you up to New Republic Wharf? And upgrade dock. And then we're going to set you to high. What does that do? I don't think that does anything. Yeah, let's get a good amount of service crew and a good amount of Marines. And then we can... Ship is already scheduled for modification. We have to do that later. That's fine. Are we close to this Dreadnought? This thing is running. Like, actually. Sorry. We do have a good set of Marines on here, so we should be okay. Speaking of that, what else are we looking at? Let's see. Oh, the VCX 100. Somebody said something about wanting to see more of the ships, so that will be what I am doing. The VCX 100 is actually a really cool ship. It's basically the ghosts from Rebels, if you watch Rebels. I enjoyed Rebels. Some people didn't, but I think it was essential to the Star Wars lore. But the VCX 100 is pretty cool. Within the X3 mod, you could dock a fighter on each side, so it was a perfect medium ship to go for if you didn't have one, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. Because I think that was my goal for a large portion of gameplay that I had. So, but for now, it's a little... I don't think it can dock, so it is not going to be my preferred. Honestly... My preferred, I believe, in general, was the Raider Corvette for the X3 mod. I want to have a different, like, M ship for my preferred, transport my daily. But it's I'm only using the Hammerhead just because it has so many guns on it, and its forward and ventral guns are pretty powerful. And I just use it for boarding. That's literally it. This is... Do I not have this named? You know what? Let's pause this and rename it SVS Infiltrator, just because of what it's used for boarding. So, all right, listen, you've been piloting. That's fine. Can I select you? Why is it lagging like that? Dreadnought class cruiser. All right, cool. Start guidance. The lag is painful, but it's okay. Eventually, whenever the mod gets updated, we should be good. And then whenever we restart, or not restart, but start the second campaign, after we get to what we're going to be doing, I think the Anawat Federation is just our main goal for, it was originally the Empire, but I think our goal is to set up a stone for us to stand upon to fight the Empire. So I think our goal for the campaign and where we're going to end it is either wiping out the Anawat Federation entirely, or just getting a good base, like around half or so of their territory, and then we should be good. Gotta get a little bit closer. Oi. All right, good. just get within range. Nice. Okay, well, first, let me pause it. Let's set our turrets to attack fighters. So as soon as they come in range, they are going to light them up. We should be good. All right, as long as we're out of range or sight of their main guns, we should be okay. So I'm set it to attack my current enemy. And then I'm going to select this one. Or no, I'm going to select this one. Can you guys, like, deal with that, please? They are shooting me a lot. If I have to turn around to deal with these, I'm going to be very upset. Looks like I'm going to have to turn around to deal with them. My turns are a little slow. But it's okay. Just deal with that, please. Cool. Where is this one? It's literally blending in. Cool. Dead. We can use this to get whatever was on there. Which I don't know what it was. Alright. Turns can open fire on the dreadnought. Ooh, we are straying out of its back. Alright. Let's get in our optimal position. Start lighting up the engines. The dreadnought seems to be one of the easier ships to board. And I'm okay. I'm completely fine with it. I don't, like, some people, like, might see this as, like, cheesing it. I don't see it as cheesing it because I'm using a strategy. The dreadnoughts are the easier ships to board, so that's going to be my goal. This is how I'm going to make a lot of my money and my large ship capacity. This is my goal for a short time. While that's happening, let's actually go ahead and... Can I get out of this menu, please? Thank you. Let's go to board. Oh, we need to scan. That's right. Shift 2, scan, boom. Yeah, it's been like a week since I've opened the game, so this is my first time on in a bit. Actually, wait, am I getting shot at? By what? Alright, let me get closer. There you go, that's better. Alright, set board. What is the capacity? So boarding resistance? Wait, how many ships? They have 4 crew? Hello? Okay. Well, I guess I'll just board with one veteran and win? Okay. This one guy is going to go in there and massacre these 4 people. All right. Combat effectiveness. Let's go with very strong. And hull. Let's go with strong. And then it's going to reach the target. Is it going to hit? Yeah, because it's just going to go in the back. Can my guns not shoot, like my boarding pod? Cool. All right. We're going to light up these. Oh, it's so close. I feel like my guns are going to hit my own boarding pod. I don't know if that's a thing. I very much so hope it is not. All right. I'm going to let my guns chill out for a second. Just to cool down, it is at 96%. And I have upgraded this hammerhead with the ship mod. So the infiltrator is our designated boarding ship, at least for dreadnoughts or whatever abilities we were planning. Boom. Done. All right. Now I just need to protect it. You should be good. I'm not even worried about you right now. Oh, did not mean to press that. Can we... What is this? Oh, that's fine. All right, well, while those turrets are mad that I can't do anything, or that I can't do anything, that's right. I'm just going to boost my way out of its firing arc. Zooming. I don't know how far away it is. I think 13... kilometers was the safe range. 11 to 13, somewhere around there. All right, we should be in safe proximity. Cool. Oh, there's an arc fighter that wants the smoke. Hey, buddy, you sure you want to do this? Like, I don't think you know what you're getting into. Just saying. Hey, let's boost so we can get a little bit closer to let our guns open up. Yeah. Can't turn fast enough. Can I turn, please? Thank you. Jeez. Goodbye. Goodbye. Nice. Goodbye. There we go. All right, that dreadnought will definitely be ours. If it's not, I'm actually going to be sad. It's fine. I don't see another dreadnought on the scanners. So let us make our way back to the equipment dock. Start guidance, autopilot, done. All right, let's see how this is going down here. All right, this is clear. They're good. And then these are clear. They're good. Cool. Okay, let's see these fleets. The ones I created. All right. Cool. All right, so I'm going to tie in a couple of them. I'm going to try to use as many as possible from the names people gave me. So this one is going to be Skull Squadron. Actually, I have an idea. Okay. So the Y-Wings are actually going to be Hammer Squad. Hammer 1, Hammer 2, Hammer 3, all the way up to Hammer 10. And then I'm going to have an L-ship. Not sure which one. Going to be the SVS Anvil. So it's going to be the Hammer and Anvil. That would actually be pretty cool. All right, I think that's what I'm going to do. All right, I'm going to move you down here just so I know. All right, rename you to, let's go with Skull Squad. Customs. What is following you? One TIE Defender and one Hammerhead. You're going to be attacked with. All good. All right, the SVS Harbinger is doing its thing. Okay, but let's actually stop this. Let's send our capital ship, remove all orders. We're going to send our capital ship back to SVS Prime. I'm sorry, what's going to blow? Wait, where's my ship? Bruh. Wait, I'm so confused. Oh, it's back here. We already captured it. Cool. All right, nice. All right, well, we're going to send it to the equipment dock. We can't send it to the equipment dock because we don't have... Oh, there's no pilot. Okay, that's why. I was very confused. All right, Erin Giorno, you will become captain. Come down here. You can't upgrade because we don't have large ship capacity. We can come down here and upgrade you, though, which is good because the huts actually accept dreadnoughts because they make them, so they have all the things we need. I don't think I destroyed a single turret, so I'm not even stressing about it right now. We will repair it, though. Boom, crew. We'll set up a good amount of Marines and a good amount of service crew. Nice consumables. We will sell the satellites because we don't need those. We'll keep the flares, and I think that's good. All right, how much is this going to cost? 500,000? Basically, 500,000 and one Marine for a fully kitted out dreadnought. I will absolutely take that any day of the week. However, where are we at? I think... No, I don't want to go there. I was thinking about going into this sector, but no. I will acquire a ship to do it for me, however. I think I'm gonna come down to the Kaminoans because the Delta 7 is actually pretty fast. Small. Delta 7. I don't know if the ETAS or 2 or the Delta 7 has higher speed. So let's go with... Alright, so their speed is 342 and their travel speed is 684. This is 365 and travel speed is 69. Really? I thought the Delta 7 would be faster, but all right, I guess the ETAS is awesome. Let's go with that. You're good. Weapons. I'll fully kit you out just because why not? Crew, you are fine. And then consumables, get 5 advanced satellites. 700K for that ship. Perfectly fine. What am I doing? I'm just sitting here, aren't I? Yeah. I don't think there are any other ones in this sector. You're going to repair yourself. You're fine. All right, let's actually head back to the... What is my goal right now? My goal is the Anowet Federation, but I'm too busy over here grinding these dreadnoughts. I need more money. All right, you can actually come and... Yeah, let's just autopilot that. All right. What's going on down here? All right. Skull. What is this? This is a hammer squad. All right. Hammer squad will actually... Oh, this is such a mess over here. There's no coordination. All right. We have the SVS Harbinger. How many dock ships do you have? You have 25 dock ships. Good. Keep them docked. All right. Let's see what happens if I select everything here. What is this? So, 9 hammerheads, 2 customs, 1 raider. So there's 6 E-wings, 2 X. Okay, let's see. Can I select all of the X-wings? Cool. All the X-wings. Oh no. Oh. Okay, that's fine. And select all of you and remove all orders and assignments. I'm gonna set all of you to come down here. What should I have be their leader? Wait, this is Skull Squadron, is it not? Oh, auto save. Yay, my favorite part of the game. Kashyyyk. All right, Hammer Squad. Oh no, I had a Hammer Squad selected, but it wasn't this. All right, cool. All of you guys will be individually selected, and I think what should lead? We have what is this a TIE Defender? If this is a TIE Defender, the Defender will be the lead. Skull Squadron. Where is Skull Squadron? Did I rename the... I think I renamed the TIE Defender to Skull Squadron. All right, whatever. All right, you're going to attack with your commander. And then you will be renamed the Fleet. Nice. Skull Squadron. All right, cool. I'm getting messages on Discord, so... All right. All right, we have this. Okay, we're going to set up with, what is this? Information, backwards cross. Let's go with backwards X shape. All right, we're going to bring you down here with Hammer Squad. We're going to line up all of our individual fighter fleets. We have a lot of Hammerhead Corvettes over here. I don't know what to do with most of these. All right, so all of you, let's select all these Hammerheads. Actually, let's go with half. We're going to set... 4 or 5 to, I don't want to intercept. We're going to set attack with, because the hammerheads have good heavy guns. And then we're going to set these 4 and the SVS Relentless to, okay. These 4 and the SVS Relentless is going to go ahead and attack with the SVS Griffin. So, Captain Talon, you are now in command of your own strike force. I was going to say fleet, but I guess it's not really a fleet. We have a second Arquintons. What are you doing? You're just chilling there. Okay. What about... Okay, all the fighters... Oh, okay, I see. You're mimicking you. All right, you can stop that. And you can... Not mimic. You can attack with. Because that is your main goal. All right, Delta is going to be the... frigates and XLs, Hammerhead Corvette. Are you policing? What are you doing? What is happening? What are you attacking? Why are you attacking that? I'm so confused. Where are these guys coming from? They're literally dropping out of the SVS Bulwark just to jump this Gazanti miner. Understandable, I guess. Right, attack. Go ahead and protect ship. No, you're good. All right, you will be... All right, customs. 1, 2, and 3 will actually be set to defend. Nice. And then you guys are set to what? Attack with... I hate that it's saying that it wants to dock. What? Stop docking. Done. All right, cool. This Quasar, however, for some reason, we just don't have fighters for it. I think we swapped out all of our fighters and put them in, wait, what am I doing with this? Oh, you're coming up here to put, satellites in the Nazari sector. All right, actually, we're gonna do one here. Boom. And then you're gonna do one right out of the gate. Mm-hmm. Then you're gonna do one, like, all the way over here. And then one all the way over here. And then one at the top of the corner, because why not? And then that's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. And then after that, you are going to pull out and you are going to be a part of this squadron. Are you on intercept? No, you're set to defend. You'll be a part of this defend afterwards. No! Gosh dang it. Okay, it's fine. Come here, drop this. Come here, drop this. I love how 90% of this game right now is just fleet management. Drop that, and then at the top of the corner, drop that. Cool. And then you can just come back and wait with this fleet. All right, your orders are set. You're fine. This dreadnought is going to repair itself. It's still in Neuter. That's weird. All right. You are in Felucia. You are in Korriban. Perfectly fine. Good. You're also in Korriban. This delta is in Dorman Kos. All right, we're actually going to get all of these. And you're going to be set to attack with this Arc 170. So you guys gotta make your way. All right, ETAS, you have your orders. Dreadnought has its orders. These miners are doing mining things. This miner's getting attacked from what? Whoa. Why are you getting jumped? Where are you at? You're just getting jumped in CSA space? All right, cool. Thought we were cool with the CSA, but guess not. Let's buy something from the large. Oh, we don't have the money. We only have 1.5 million. Can we buy an Arquintus? No, we can't. Shame. That sucks. All right, we're probably going to lose that miner, but it's okay. I don't know why I'm paused. All right, back to double checking. You guys have your orders, orders. SVS Crop Duster, you're actually not doing anything because you're upgrading. Did I tell you to come up here and upgrade? Oh, no, you're good. Let's set the SVS Crop Duster. We'll send you in here. This Raider Corvette is kind of the only one not doing anything at the moment. So this Raider Corvette will be set to attack with the SVS Crop Duster. That's good. And then all of our... I wonder, so if we... So we have these fighters. So if I tell these fighters just to... dock and wait. Are they still a part of their own fleet? Because I hope so. Skull Squadron, come and dock. Dock and wait. Okay, yeah. They look like they're a part of their own fleet, so we don't really have to worry about it. That's good. What is this TIE Defender doing? Interception for what? Oh, your reactionary force. Response range. Cool. Alright, what about all the ships docked for this? What is this? This is the Harbinger. Oh, no, this is the Hellbringer. Cool. All right, I'm going to select literally every single ship that is attached to this. Okay. And this Y-Wing. Cool. I'm going to need all of you to remove assignment. I need all of you to just come and chill over here. 26 selected ships. All right, you guys have your orders. You're undocking massively at the same time. All right, what about you? We're gonna do the same thing with you because you have a large contingent of fighters on you. And this is the Harbinger, okay. Now select every single one of you and every single one of you. Cool. I'm gonna need you guys to remove your assignments and then just come and chill over here so we can set them up properly. I don't know if people enjoy this like small fleet management stuff, but I'm gonna do it anyways. All right, you guys are good. Don't you have like a... Yeah, you have a formation. A line abreast, I see. Let's do inverse V-shape. And then let's actually move you closer to here. So we can see that formation actually come to pass. And we're in the sector, so it's actually going to take a minute. All right. We're looking good here. Our ship is good. What is next other than this dreadnought? There's another what are you? You are just a large squadron of... You know what? What are you? You guys are set to defense. I'm going to set you guys to intercept, actually. Is it all of you or... I don't know, but I'm going to change it manually. Yeah, all of you. Boom. Intercept. And this hammerhead is actually going to come and support... this star chaser or this star builder. Why? Because we're good people and we don't like seeing pirates attack. what are you, TST? That's Twin Suns. I believe that's a Tatooine corporation, I think. Just because, you know, Twin Suns, and I hear the Tatooine music in the background, and it's just making me think of Tatooine. All right, poor axes are going to engage. Oh, they are on top of him. Oh my god. Oh my gosh, he got shredded. Absolutely shredded. That's funny. It's actually really funny. All right, the Borax will deal with that. We should be good. Borax seem to be pretty heavy, at least for a, what's the word, fighter? Do I have a Kamagla? I do have a Kamagla. Are you set to, you're set to defense. All right, I'm going to need you to dock then. And then you can defend from being docked. What about you? You're set to defense. All right, I'm going to set you to defend this one. And then you're going to be set to dock. All right, this hammerhead. Oh, okay, okay, okay. So we're going to set this hammerhead to a... No. This Dornian gunship needs to be set to... oh, we have two Dornian gunships. I don't remember anything that happened in the previous episodes. Ah. All right, we're going to change both of you guys to interception because that is kind of your main goal. You are a gunship, you are a picket line, and your goal is to take care of fighters. Are we making a lot of money? I genuinely can't tell. What is our freaking shipyard at? Let's go to logical overview. You are at 200 million. Well, maybe we are making a lot of money. However, you are very much so out of Rhydonium. And or. How do I get more Rhydonium? Can I create buy offer? For the most... I need more Rhydonium. Rhydonium, and what is this? Silicon wafers. Oh, I see. So we need silicon ore and rhydonium. We just need more mining ships specifically for this. Okay, well, how do? Okay, well, let's make some mining ships. Don't we? Do we have? Wait, not plan build. But yeah, this is my like my masterpiece of a station. By the way, ignore that. Logical overview. I'm looking at the wrong things. Build ships. Thank you. If we go to medium sized. We have miners, yeah. Only the Beria, though. So, let's grab these. Oh, that's why. Because we don't have the equipment. All right, cool. All right, so that gives us a goal that we can go do. So, I'm going to take the hammerhead, and we are going to come down here to Imperial Ascendancy space and dock. I'm gonna get out. Hello. And then have you guys just go and dock. Wait, you can stop following that ship. You have your orders. These builders have their own tasks. What about this wharf? How much money is this wharf made? What is this? Its storage is almost full. Oh, okay. Good logical overview. Station account. 50 million. Okay. That's not bad at all, actually. Let's accept the estimate and get 9 million. All right. There is another wharf up here, I think, that I wanted to check out. I don't think this is ready yet, but just to double check. Logical overview. Yeah, you're not ready. 29 million. Oof. Actually, you know what? Since we just got 9 million, let's stick some money in here. Oh, we have 13 million at the moment. Let's stick like 7 million just so they can start buying things and actually producing things. Cool. All right, you guys are the Chandrila Huntress. You guys are set to intercept. And then this is a Neutron Star Builder. Let's change your name to the SVS. What is a good name? The SVS Uncle. I think that's funny. Oh. SVS Uncle. Cool. I will set your position to find auto build tasks. Yeah, because you're not doing anything. Make some money. Appreciate it. What other stations should I check? Oh, what about this wharf? Oh, no, this wharf has 50 million. This wharf has 200 million. However, we need more, so I'm just going to let this 200 million sit. Tuning software right there. All right, so we have all of these fighters down here in this tiny clump. Whoa, 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 whoa. ETAS? Hold on. Escape. Whoa, 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 you're getting attacked. I kind of expected it, but at the same time, where are you? Is it dead? I think it's dead. I think it just died. Because it dropped the satellite, and its command was to go in here and drop a satellite. I think it died before it even got a chance to drop out a satellite. All right, bro. I don't want to waste money on this, though. Let's buy some vulture droids, because they're cheap. Vulture droids. Let's go with on the low preset. 200 a pop. And then we can add one advanced satellite to each. So it's 250 a pop. Add it up to 4, and for 1 million, we have quadrupled our chances of getting a satellite down. I want to see what is in this sector. I don't want to attack it, because they seem to constantly be producing dreadnoughts. I don't know whether there's a shipyard in the sector or not, but we need to find out. Alright, cool, we're doing that. Why are you not moving? You have commands to go to the Imperials, so we can go buy stuff. Wait. Or stop waiting. Alright. You're good. Dreadnought is good as well. You're set to defense. Set you to attack, but it's fine. You still have the same method for things that you need to do. All right. Let's see. Let's go back to our fighters that are kind of just chilling. Are our vulture droids, like, already done? Did I see that right? Oh my gosh. All right. All right, cool. Let's send you guys here. And then the first one is going to drop one right here. We're lagging right now severely for whatever reason. Second one is going to drop one here. I'm not even going to worry about getting them out, to be honest. Third one is going to drop one here. Fourth one is going to drop one here, and I'm going to change the first one because I told it to drop a satellite here, but we already have one. I don't know why I set it to do that, so I'm going to move you to be further out this way. Cool. All right, they have their goals. Let's actually set each and every one of you, because they should be at the same speed. Yeah, they should be at the same speed, so I'm going to set each one of them to forget their fly and wait, and then just immediately go to drop off the satellite. All right, cool. All right, this Arc 170. This fleet will be named. The Explorer Squadron, because they're in the middle of Drummond Cost. So fleet, we have Explorer Squadron, we have the SVS Harbinger. Ooh, we can rename, I forgot we can rename, like, just the fleet. So instead of Fleet 12, this is going to be the Harbinger was our first one, actually. So this will be the first expeditionary fleet. And then the Hellbringer will be the second defense fleet. I like these names. These are cool. Second defense fleet. You have your orders. And all you guys are kind of just waiting here. All right, cool. I can set you up individually then. All right, so all of these Y-Wings will group together. You'll be set to... Sure. Let's just set you to mimic commander's behavior. Because if I need them to attack, they're all going to attack. Hello? Jump completed. Map free. Alright, well, I'm gonna need all of you guys to attack with, actually. Wait, no, you need to... Okay, cool. That's good. Alright. Alright, all these Y-Wings will be renown. Can I rename the fleet? No, I can't, because it's not a fleet. Let's set you to attack with. And let's set you to not defense. And then it's going to be a fleet, technically. So you're going to be the renamed fleet. The Mirror Squadron. Nice. All right. So Mirror Squadron, your goal is going to be to... Oh, dude, the lag is insane. Like, I can't. Why am I lagging? I don't understand. Please stop. Game, stop it. Like, there's no reason I should be lagging in a menu. All right, Mirror Squadron down here. So we have Mirror Squadron. Fine. I'm going to have you guys move just so you're out of the way of the rest of these fighters. All right, what about the rest of y'all? What have y'all been doing? All right, 13 X-Wings. What? We have 3 Y-Wings here? I'm sorry. Why? Wing? Haha, see what I did? Okay, I'm sorry. All right, this Y... Actually, let's go to object list. So these 3 Y-Wings are also going to be a part of the squadron, which is attack with. So Mirror Squad is going to be a bombing run squad. And all of these X-Wings are going to be set to... Let's set to attack with as well. Boom. And then let's change you to... Oh, can I change the fleet name? No, because it's not a fleet technically. That's weird. Are you... Command... Okay, stop that. I'll set you to... What's the word? Rename fleet. Shadow Squadron. Nice. X-Wings are going to be set to Shadow Squadron. Alright, I'm going to set all of you guys to actually mimic the commander's behavior. And I'm going to set you to... I'm going to set you to intercept the vent for the Venator. Intercept for commander. You're going to be Kappa. And then after, I'm going to have you dock and wait. So they will all follow the same order. All right, you guys are all good. Nice. You guys are a problem. I'm going to have all of you guys set to... All right, let's set all of you guys to mimic as well for Kappa. And then your goal is going to be to attack with. Ah, auto save. Cool. All right, as I was saying, you are going to be set to I completely forgot what I was doing. Attack with. Oh, okay. Attack with. We'll set you to Ada. And with that being said, let's pause this real quick because I don't even know where the commander of this small fleet. Oh no, that's why, because I have all of you in. You're in the second defense fleet. Okay. I'll just leave it at that. Should be good. I do not want you guys to dock. Please stop trying to dock. Nice. And both of these squadrons are trying to dock with the Quasar. It has 2 dock ships. It can carry 32. And there are... What? Can I... Why can I not select all of these? Let's go with object list. Hammer squad. Okay. Skull squad. That's the singular one. And then hammer squad. Oh, I see. Okay, so it's in the fleets. I was renaming the ships instead of the actual fleet name. Okay, so wherever this... Okay, let's drop all these down. Explorer Squadron. The Griffin, SVS Uncle, Dreadnought, Hammerhead, I see. Okay, so rename fleet to Hammer Squad. I feel like I shouldn't do this, but I kind of want to. I think I'm gonna go through all of these all of these ships and then rename them to Hammer and their designated number in the team. Hammer 4. I'm gonna do most of it off camera. I'm just gonna finish this one squad. I did not want to redesign you. Rename. This is going to be Hammer 5. That M looked so off-putting to me. Rename to Hammer 6. Yes, I'm going to be very tedious and rename every single one of these while on camera. Hammer 7. Rename. Hammer 8. Rename. Hammer 9. Oh, no music. Oh, copyright. Oh, I'm dying. Get out of my head. Akira. I'm sorry. That's stuck in my head. And Hammer 10. No. Hammer 10 is at the top. I don't like that. Do not like that at all. That's okay. All right. Hammer 1 is in the lead. I'll worry about Skull Squadron later. The Venator isn't doing anything. You're fine. I will make you move over here, however. And what is this little squadron? The SVS Griffin and its escort ships. The SVS Griffin is definitely an attack fleet. I had a pause. I forgot. Definitely one that will do a bunch of damage. All right, cool. You know what I want to do? So we're going to make our way to the Ascendancy just so we can buy some of the parts for these miners and things that we need. I'm gonna buy some miners. Actually, oh wait, there's a mining guild. Oh no, you won't be able to get out of Animat space. Never mind. Let's buy some miners from the Imperials up here. Buy ships. Medium. Let's get... I know we can get the Gazanti miners, but I'm gonna get just the Berea miners. We're gonna go with high. Ooh, high, really? Okay, wait, what's the difference? Okay, so mainly flares, not much there. What about... Okay, what's the weapons? Laser cannons, minimum. So even on low, it's... Oh, there's not a much difference between low and high. Okay, I'm gonna do low. Add to shopping. We're gonna grab 3 of these. Just because we're gonna get as many as we can just to mine specifically for the station. Is the station almost out of storage? No, station is very good on storage. Oh, there's like so many corpses around here. It's insane. It's fine. SVS Bulwark, what are you doing? Are you doing a trade? Oh, you're set to auto trade. Okay, cool. That's a random miner. I don't know why ANO like ships just keep coming in my sector for whatever reason. You guys should have learned your lesson. All right, the Quasar. Rename. The SVS Mother. Because it carries little ones. I'm going to refer to every fighter as a little one. I'm sorry, little one. I'm going to stop reciting memes before I lose all of the subscribers that I've gained recently. Also, on top of that, as of right now, I'm definitely going to keep up updates in this series just so I can like look back on it, since this was like one of the first ones that definitely got a lot of views and looks. So as of right now, my subscriber count is 573. Guys, I don't think you understand how much of an achievement that is, because 28 days ago, I was less than that. I was at 60-something. In the past 28 days, I have gained 504 subscribers. And that's not even whenever I started uploading the X4 video. It was a little bit over that. So technically, as soon as I started uploading, I was at 33 subs. I've gained over 520 subscribers. That is absolutely insane. I appreciate every single one of you. We are at 36,000 views. That's crazy. And it's only gonna go up. And I was thinking about it. I'm not sure, but somebody said something about trying Empire at War mods. I played Empire at War a while back, but I was never super good at it. I might try it, but I don't know. It's like old classic RTS. Which again, there's nothing wrong with it, but I haven't played it in forever, so we'll see how it goes. And I definitely appreciate it whenever you guys not contribute, but you guys set to attack with. Yeah, you're doing your thing. But I appreciate you when you guys participate in like polls and stuff. It is so like it makes me happy to see that you guys want to be a part of it. Oh, wait a minute. Speaking of that, I'm looking at the names that some of you have commented, and I'm actually going to change this one right here because somebody has a name for specifically a character carrier. Instead of the SVS Mother, it will be the SVS Mantle's Approach. And then this is going to be Captain Lazu. Screw it, we'll go for the whole one. Captain Lazurkri. That's good. Yeah, there's a lot of good recommendations. All of you guys have good recommendations. I love the concept of the SVS Crop Duster, just this tiny rinky-dink CR90 that can outrun anything. It's so great. I love it. But you have your command. You guys are struggling with docking right now, and I'm not sure why. How many docked ships do you have? Hold on. What is all of your commands? I see. That's why. What is this? Hammer Squad? Okay. Let's grab Hammer Squad. Gonna change all of you guys to Mimic. So you guys can dock as well. Because they're not docking because they're mimic or they're attacking with the commander. But since the commander isn't attacking, it's just chilling there docking, they're not gonna do anything. But since I have it set to Mimic, they will dock. I need to do the same thing with the Skull Squadron. Skull Squadron, you are docked. I will set you guys to Mimic. So soon they'll start docking a little bit more. SCS Mantle's approach still only has 2 docked ships, but that's fine. All right, where are we at? I forgot what I was going to say. We are going to the Ascendancy space, but I think I'm going to start looking at some of the Bounty Hunters Guild stations just to see what... Where's the closest BHG? Ew, it's an Anawat space. Second closest is up here in Mongaza, and that's the headquarters, so that's fine, I guess. But we're gonna be looking at some bounties specifically against the Anawat Federation and see if we can target those, like get a strike force in. Maybe if they have it in Sump, maybe we can fly like through the sector as quick as possible, hit in Sump, and then get out basically before they can respond. All right, are you guys docking? I can't tell. You guys look as if... Okay, what if I tell you to... Okay, what if I tell you to fly and wait? And then come and dock and wait again. Same thing with you. Fly and wait, and then come and dock and wait.
Jump completed.
Alright. See if you guys will dock. Oh, wait. Actually, I don't even need you guys to be doing that. I can just... Well... No, yeah. Yeah, I don't need you guys to do that. I can just have you, where are the squads? Or the fleets? Hammer Squad. I'm gonna set all of you guys back to attack with. Which is fine. But then I'm gonna have you guys just dock and wait. And then I'm gonna set all of you guys back to attack with. There we go, that's better. And I'm just gonna set you guys back to dock and wait. Boom. Nice, 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 nice. Cool. How many ships do you have docked SVS Mantle's approach? You have... I don't know. Enough. They're docking. That's all I can see. That's all I care about. Cool. Where are we at? We're coming down here. All these ships are going to repair. Oh, I have a defense platform up here. What is happening on the NRL and Imperial front? Nothing. Vortex is as contested as usual. What about Chardon and Follis, Coruscant? All right, right here is, where is it? Follis, right here. Yeah, as a, oh my god. The Anawat Federation is pulling it out. Escort Quasar, Patrol Valor. Just because they're at war with the same people that the Imperials are at war with. I don't know, maybe we can get away with a few strikes. And especially since they're going to be, especially since they're going to be up here fighting, that means that they're going to have killed a lot of things, which is going to mean that they're going to have a lot of bounties on them, and that means that their bounty is going to be higher. So that might be a goal. Okay, cool. I think I know what we're going to do. All right, let me move you down here. I'm going to have you mine for a commander. Also, wait, who is telling me to get spaced? Star Chaser? Bro. Oh. Okay. All right, I'm actually going to pull. Let's pull the, you know what, since we have the strike force, let's use our new fleets. Let's pull out the SVS Griffin of the, oh no, that's the ship, renamed fleet of the 34th. That's not a 3, of the 34th strike force. All right. Alright, the 34th Strike Force is going to come and assist me, basically. I should have used... I was going to use the defense fleet because, you know, they're defending, but it's fine. What do you have protecting you? Hammerheads, Can any of these ships? I know the SVS Relentless can, but what about? I don't think so. All right, let's see what we can do with some of these unassigned ships, basically fighters. So we have one in SVS Prime. Cool, cool. And then all of. Oh, we don't have too many. All right. You will actually come and be a part of the 34th, and I'm going to set you to intercept, or actually, let's go with attack with, Commander, just so we can have at least one fighter. We'll get some more. I'm not worried about it. We need to kit out your fleet, because I feel bad having... Oh, that's a minor. I thought that was something else. It was about a trip. Okay, looks like we're doing pretty good on the defense side. Are all of you docked? Cool. All right, the SVS Mantle's approach has 20 ships docked. That means two squadrons of 10. Hey, that works out perfect. All right, are you guys doing your thing? You are nowhere near it. Okay, cool, whatever. Where are we at? We are closer to ascendancy space. All right, we're about to get into Iriadu. All good. Scrapper's doing your thing. You're in Kashyyyk. Okay, your engines have mostly repaired, I'm assuming. Good. Gazanti Imperial Transport. What are you doing? Nothing. Why aren't you doing anything? Trade for Commander? Sure. I guess. Wait, can I have you just set to... No. You don't have a good pilot? Where did you come from? I am so confused. Okay, whatever. All good. Alright, trade for Commander. You're doing that. What are you doing? That's me. That's the infiltrator. And the Mantle's approach. What should the Mantle approach be part of? So it's the first expeditionary fleet or the second defense fleet. I think it's going to be a part of the expeditionary. I think it just makes sense. How about you follow? You're not going to attack. What is... Okay, so you have... The Mantle's approach. You have all of these squadrons. You have... Wait. Hold on. I'm so confused. Alright, so they are set to attack for the Mantle's approach? I'm confused. Or are you still in your fleets? No, they're still in their fleets. Dock, escort ship. Escort... Okay, so you're escorting... What ship? I'm so confused. Alright, how about I set you to intercept for... What are you? Your Skull Squadron? Cool. You're gonna intercept for this. Nice. You should stay docked. And then Hammer Squadron, you are going to be set to... What's the word? We'll set to attack with. Sure. We'll set you to attack with. Boom. You still... Hopefully you guys don't undock. You have no need to. Cool. You're staying docked. Cool. You got it. Good job. I love how I'm saying good job to AI. I'm a nice person, guys. All right. You guys are over here. What are you doing? These Porax are pouring onto the Sark 170. You're fine. I'm going to send you to attack. Target some range. If anything else comes in range, you'll be fine. The SVS. This is a Dreadnought. Ooh, I have a good name. Speaking of Dreadnought. So this is going to be the... No, that's the fleet name. Hold on. This is going to be renamed the SVS Fearmonger. Oh, yeah. And then rename fleet to the 73rd. 73rd what? 73rd Revolutionary. 73rd. Ooh, how about the 73rd Vanguard? Vanguard fleet. No. 73rd backline. 73rd. Seventy-third coverage fleet. Let's go with that. Nice. Okay, cool. Explorer Squadron, SVS Bulwark. You're doing your thing. I have a bunch of fighters. Just can you just like dock, please? You have no need to be. Can I? My game froze. Oh, I love X. It's just a lot of stuff. Okay, cool. I'm just gonna have you guys just dock and wait. Boom. And then you can support him from the inside. Nice. Alright, this isn't really a fleet. This is just you being you. The crop duster. What do I have with you? I have one Raider Corvette. Oh yeah, because I don't know what I'm gonna set you up with. How about we go with I was gonna do like the blockade runner, but no, that's I don't like that. That's weird. Add this hammerhead. Okay, we can rename this fleet to the 49th response fleet. And the hammerhead will be known as the SVS. I want something that's like stamping out piracy. SVS Sentinel. I know how to spell Sentinel. Alright, nice. Alright. I love how half of this episode is just naming things, but I think it's so cool having these individual like fleets and everything set up. Why is my screen like just gray? Oh, that's just where we're at. I thought it was like that was weird. I just have to say, like, the design of the Hammerhead Corvette is insane. I love it so much. The entire concept of the Hammerhead Corvette is just being able to have as much forward facing firepower as possible. But the thing is, the Hammerhead Corvette, it didn't even start off as a Corvette. It started off as a cruiser. And this is from the Old Republic. Like, the Hammerhead Cruiser, it was a much larger ship and had much more firepower. But that's the whole point of the ship. It's a slim ship to where whenever it's approaching its target, it has as small a basically hitbox as possible and as much damage facing out as possible. It's a cool concept, and I think it's done right. Also, I'm lagging like crazy because we are in Ascendancy core space, and there is a lot of ships around here. Let's go to the representative's office. Let's get out of here as fast as possible. I don't want to be stuck here with like 10 FPS. Hopefully with 6.0 it will get fixed. Hopefully. All right. Let's see. Show me your blueprints. Let's go with not ships. I already have most of your ships, don't I? Not the L's, but most of the mediums, yeah. Let's go with equipment. What about engines? What don't I own? What is up here? The Beria engine. Cool. I'll take that because I don't own that. I think that's actually like the only thing I came here for, to be honest with you. That's fine. I do want to check out. Okay, research. Yeah, full teleport. Ooh, and habitation module hack. And we have basically everything. Nice. Oh, and it's going to be done in a couple seconds. How do I hack these? Allows the possibility to steal blueprints from. Ah, I see. I see, says the blind man. All right, let's actually go back to our ship. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to set you to leave. Come down here to Dagobah. There's like nothing in Dagobah. Please. The ship will be undocking soon. Yep, you are more than welcome to carry on with your current orders. Proceed. What about the fleet that I told to come up here? They were late. If there was ANO, this is why is this so laggy? Oh my god, I am going to lose it. I guess this is what happens whenever you're later in the games. This is why 90% of the games later on is just like filled in a menu. So you're not noticing how bad things are lagging. It's fine though. What is this? Not the defense fleet. SVS Griffin. Oh, cool. You're still doing your thing, attacking this Y-Wing, because that takes forever for whatever reason. All right, SVS Venator. SVS Venator, yeah. I love that. That's okay, bro. That's funny. Customs Corvette, this is the defense fleet. Let's set up. Oh, you guys are doing your thing. Cool. Did I do every single one of your? I don't think I did your fighters. It has been about an hour now, so I'm going to continue to record, even though I'm just going to be setting up fighters. If you don't care to see that, you're more than welcome to go. I appreciate you for coming out, and I'll see you in the next one. But if you want to sit here and watch me, like, fumble over names and typing, then you're more than welcome to stay. I'm going to set this TIE Defender too. You're going to remove your interception command, and you're going to come out here. The rest of this episode is just going to be ship naming. Not like that wasn't what a majority of this episode was. Actually, the episode won't be ship naming. I'm going to Mon Gaza to do the bounty thing, because that's what I said I was going to do, and I am not a liar. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum. We are farmers. Cool. Anyways, is that copyright? I hope that's not copyright. All right. Bounty Hunters Guild Station. Also, another thing that I wanted to say. So, with a lot of the Twitch updates, because I stream a lot of games on Twitch, but they have been basically cracking down on sponsors and everything. I don't, like, Twitch is working so hard, like, so hard to make the worst decisions possible for whatever reason. But it is what it is. I'm just gonna leave them alone. So I will be pulling a little bit away from Twitch. I'm still gonna stream on there at least like twice a week, but for the most part, I think my focus is gonna be on YouTube now, because I have a YouTube fam now. I won't forget about my stream family, but we will be toning it down a bit for the streams, and then maybe I might switch streaming over to YouTube. Not sure. You are set to. Wait. I'm sorry. What is this? Mercenary class? What is your command? Isn't it like plunder? It's set to plunder. What are you plundering? Better not be any of my shifts. Get out of my sector, bro. This is ascendancy mercenaries too. Oh? Hello, Mr. Dreadnought. Is this the one we've already claimed? No, this is another one. There has to be a shipyard in the... And there's another one. There has to be a shipyard in the sector. Like, there... It... Alright. Well, let us go... towards. I'm gonna set guidance to this target. I'm actually gonna, yeah, okay, we're gonna go to the Bounty Hunters Guild, but I'm gonna keep my target on that. All right, we're doing good. I need to get better defense platforms because mine apparently don't hold up that well. It's fine. You're doing good, man. I appreciate the work you're doing. What's that, 180 million? Where did the other 20 million randomly go? I'm so confused. All right, so we need more Rhydonium. Ugh, that sucks. We need more Rhydonium, and we basically just need a bunch of miners. That's literally it. Wait, if I mine for... This is a question. I'm gonna change it, but so if I set them to mine for build storage, mining is or wait, can I mine for build storage? I know I can trade for build storage. Hold on, let me check. I'm not dumb, I promise. For the most part. Auto mine. What did I set you to mine for, Commander? No, you can't mine for build storage. You can. That's weird. I think I might need to get a bigger miner fleet. You know what? Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to logical overview. I'm going to take out a large. Let's take out like 30 million. Yeah. And then just build miners. All right. Build ships. Oh, I can build large ships here now. Awesome. Oh, yeah. I have the 546. Do I have? Oh, I don't have the engines. I need to buy the engines for the 546. What about the Pelta? I don't have the engines for the Pelta either. Oh, I can start producing these things now. Nice. So let's go with the cruiser. Okay, so we have engines. We just don't have thrusters. We don't have large thrusters. Interesting. We don't have large turrets either. Okay, well, we need to fix that before we start producing those things. Anyways, why is my trade thing on? Turn all these off, please. For the love of God. All right, Imperial Wharf. You guys ready for a large order? Let's set you to low. How many can I do? I can do a lot. 30. Let's set this to 19. We're gonna spend 17 million just to make sure that we have a better supply of. What about? I don't know what the. Because I have the mules mod, but I don't know the better way to use it. Like, whoa, what? Hello? Where am I at? What's attacking me? Also, why am I... What are you doing? Why are you waiting for signal? That's weird. I have a lot of setup to do. Because I want to... I have a Rhydonium factory somewhere. I think. If not, I'm about to set one up. With my stations. Refined goods. Is that production? Graphene, no. Ship technology. Production. Energy cell, plasma. I have a Rhydonium somewhere. I don't know. I'm gonna set up another one. Let's set up this Rhydonium in Sullust. Yeah, this is a good place. Is there a Rhydonium factory in here? I don't know. It's fine. There's about to be one. All right, manage plots. Let's set it to a little bit higher just so we have a little bit more room. Do I need it? Actually, let's set it down here. Create plot. I'll set you right here, because why not? Sell this factory, buy the license. Yes, continue. All right, we're going to set storage because we need a lot. We need some solids. So we're going to need a good portion of solids. We're going to have 3 solids. That's out of construction range. 3 solids. We're gonna have large containers each. Nice. All right, now we need to go to the dock modules. Let's set up. Do we want an imperial dock? No. Let's go with 1 generic pier. Can I set you to, there we go. 1 generic pier. Wait, why is that not, oh, is that just out of, ew. That's nasty. All right, move you a little bit back. Nope. Nope. There we go. Can I set you up now? What if I set you right there? Is this just out of, oof. All right. Well, what if I do this? If I close the menu. What did I just, it was Sullust Factory. Yes. I'm going to move X up, Y up, Z up one more. Couple more monies. Couple bits of more monies for perfect. Perfect. Ship productions. Yep, I'm not producing ships. Oh, well. All right, we have 1 generic pier. And then we are going to have. Wait, does it say how many ship storage? 60 ship storage, but can it hold mediums? It just says 60. Okay. What about this one? Encyclopedia. Ship storage. 60. Oh, I think it's... Oh, that's just how many can dock at the same time. I see. Let's set up... Actually, let's set up one over here. Boom. Nice. And then what else do we need? So we need... Rhydonium? Mm-hmm. What am I looking for? I'm having a stroke. Yes. Production. There we go. Refined materials. We need Rhydonium. Rhydonium refinery. Nice. Okay. I'm going to confirm all the modules. I'm going to manage the resources. Nice. I'm going to change. I'm going to accept this, and then I'm going to grab one of my ship. The SVS Uncle. Oh, no. You're kind of far. You're not far. We can use you. Come over here. All right. What else? Okay. So Rhydonium, that means that that's good. I can look at the logisticals. All right. Okay, so I need energy cells and Rhydonium to make Rhydonium core, and then Rhydonium core will store. Okay. What if I set to... Okay, so I'll set 2 energy cells. Boom. And I'll set this up. And then that's basically done. Because all it needs is that for Rhydonium. It'll just be a Rhydonium factory. Sullust Rhydonium factory. And then can I... Actually, you know what? This is going to be a factory. Let's get another one. This is going to sound weird, but trust. Okay, we're going to have the Sullust Rhydonium factory. And then we're just going to do this. This is going to be dock modules. Going to be a pier. Going to be a 6M or a 3M6S. And then just a bunch of storages. Boom. 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 And then that is literally it. It is not going to produce anything. It is just going to hold Rhydonium for our station. Now sign a builder. We have another one that's nearby. This one. Cool. Select. All right. You guys have your jobs. You know what you're gonna do. Have fun. Alright. I think now is a good time to end the episode. We have... Why is my ship just, like, having a stroke every time I... Don't worry about the lockbox. Leave. Speaking of that, can I collect your inventory? I don't know if you have anything. I appreciate you guys for coming out. I appreciate every single comment, like, and sub. Just... It means a lot to me. Even the little bits of... just like, oh, great video. Oh, this was nice. I like that. That means so much. And then somebody said something on one of my posts the other day, saying that, oh, I'm gonna watch every bit of content you produce just because of how good it is. I don't know how you're not at 1,000 subscribers yet. That meant a lot to me. Like the words of affirmation and the compliments and everything that I get. Like, trust me, it is not like wasted on me. I am humble enough to understand that I have a long way to go, but I have enough of an ego to understand that I appreciate it. If that makes sense. Whatever. I appreciate you guys for coming out, and I will see you in the next one. This is Zephyrus, signing out. Get a nice little shot. Get a nice little shot. Nice little shot. Yeah. Yeah. Cool. Peace out, everybody.